Congratulations on your purchase of XIM Apex. You're about to join a vibrant community of gamers that demand the best possible mouse experience on consoles. Through proprietary technology called smart translators, XIM Apex provides a level of mouse precision unachievable by any other gaming adapter available. XIM gamers all over the world enjoy gaming with their friends on consoles while they use the input method that suits them best. Featuring full wireless configuration through smartphones and tablets, it is simple to configure and easy to use. Welcome to the XIM community. The gaming world is constantly evolving, and we frequently release firmware updates for XIM Apex with changes and improvements. Even a new XIM Apex just purchased may have firmware that is out of date. Please make sure to check for firmware updates at xim.tech/latest. Your XIM Apex supports many types of hardware for gaming and configuration. This includes mice, keyboards, joysticks, controllers, headsets, smartphones, and tablets. It is recommended that your mouse DPI be set to maximum using your mouse manufacturer's configuration tool. It is also recommended that your TV be set to game mode. Please check our hardware compatibility list at xim.tech/hardware for any known issues with your devices. PlayStation 4 users require an extra one-time configuration step before using XIM Apex. If you plan on using a PlayStation 4 controller that comes with the PS4 Pro or Slim consoles, known as the DualShock 4 Slim, then you will need to change its communication method. From the PS4 dashboard, go to Settings, Devices, Controllers, Communication Method, and set it to Use USB Cable. If you don't do this, your XIM Apex will not function. It's now time to connect your XIM Apex to your hardware. Your XIM Apex comes with a XIM hub for connecting your mouse, keyboard or joystick, and console controller to your XIM Apex. If you prefer, you can use your own hub instead, including those integrated into gaming keyboards. Using a XIM hub isn't required, but it is recommended that you use a USB 2.0 hub if you are supplying your own. You may have a setup where your XIM Apex or hub is hard to reach or see. In those cases, you can use an extension cable. Be sure to only use high-quality certified USB 2.0 cables. A controller that matches your console must be present and connected via wired at all times to use your XIM Apex. Wireless console controllers, except for Xbox 360, are connected using standard USB cables. Please be sure to choose high-quality USB data, not charge-only cables. Connect your mouse to port 1. Connect your keyboard or joystick to port 2. And connect your controller to port 3. Always make sure your controller is off prior to use with your XIM Apex. Next, plug your XIM hub into your XIM Apex. Finally, plug your XIM Apex into your console that is already on and ready. Your XIM Apex displays different light sequences as it starts up. When first powered on, XIM Apex will display its rainbow start sequence. It will then display the color of the config currently loaded. Once your XIM Apex has connected successfully with your peripherals and console, it will display rapid flashing green lights. If you don't see these green lights, it means your XIM Apex isn't communicating correctly with your console and won't work. If this happens, the most common cause is because the USB cable being used with your controller is faulty. It is recommended that you try a different cable, and also verify you are using the latest firmware on your XIM Apex. Once your XIM Apex is ready, your controller will now work in-game, but your mouse and keyboard will not since you haven't yet created a config. It's now time to run our companion configuration app called XIM Apex Manager. XIM Apex Manager works on Android and iOS phones and tablets. go to your App Store and download and install it. Run XIM Apex Manager and continue through the welcome screen and review and accept the license agreement. Next, download latest game support for your XIM Apex. XIM Apex Manager will notify you as game updates are made available. At this point, XIM Apex Manager will try to connect to your XIM Apex over Bluetooth. When you want to connect a phone or tablet for the first time, while XIM Apex Manager is searching, press the button on your XIM Apex. Your phone or tablet will connect and will do so automatically from now on unless you pair it to a different XIM Apex. XIM Apex Manager will see that you don't have any configs under XIM Apex and direct you to create a new one. Choose the game you want to play, and then choose the console you are playing on. Every game you play, even games within the same series, has a different aiming system. XIM's smart translators are designed specifically to understand how each game aims. For this reason, if you don't choose the correct game, you will have a poor aiming experience. XIM Apex Manager will add the config to XIM Apex, and you will see your XIM Apex flash white. This means XIM Apex Manager is communicating with XIM Apex. When complete, you'll see XIM Apex display solid yellow. This means that XIM Apex flash memory is being written. Be sure to never unplug your XIM Apex while it's writing flash. XIM Apex Manager will then tell you about settings you must make to your game before you continue. All XIM smart translators assume your game sensitivity is set to maximum, so you must change that setting. Some games require additional settings be changed beyond just sensitivity, and XIM Apex Manager will offer to show you those settings. Be sure to review them and make any appropriate game setting changes, otherwise you'll have a suboptimal aiming experience. You are now ready to configure your XIM Apex. The heads-up display, or HUD, screen in XIM Apex Manager shows you what config you have loaded along with real-time key press information including the in-game action the key produces. The HUD also shows you what peripherals you have connected to your XIM Apex, and you can press on the icons to see more information about them. The HUD is where you access additional functions such as adding new configs and changing other XIM Apex settings, but now it's time to set up your mouse sensitivity and key mappings. Press the Edit Config button. Config editing is divided into multiple sections. First, update the name of your config along with its color. The color is what your XIM Apex light will display. You can also set a config load key to use to load this config. If you don't use load keys, then you'll need XIM Apex Manager to load different configs on your XIM Apex. Next, set the aim sensitivity of your mouse. If the game you are playing has unique hip and aim down sight, or ADS, aiming behavior, then you'll be able to set each independently. All changes you make are updated immediately on your XIM Apex, so you can quickly tune to your desired settings. The movement and action sections allow you to map your buttons to functions in the game. To do so, press on one, and when it says listening, press a button on your mouse, keyboard, or joystick to map it. To clear a mapping, press it twice. XIM Apex Manager assumes the game you are playing is set to its default controller button layout. If it's not, then the names you see won't match the actual actions in-game. Continue to set up your button mappings, and when you're happy with them, press Save. You will be brought back to the HUD, and changes you made will be reflected there. There are a few runtime cues your XIM Apex will display that you should be aware of. If the game you are playing has independent HIP and ADS modes, when you switch between them, you'll see your XIM Apex flash green when ADS is active, and yellow when you return to HIP. You will also see this change shown on the HUD. This way, you can be sure which of your settings are active during setup. All console shooters have a maximum turn speed limit, and every game is different. Your XIM Apex will notify you when you've exceeded that limit by flashing red. This means you are moving your mouse faster than the game can turn, and you may or may not feel it. If you do feel it, it's recommended you adjust by slowing your mouse speed into turns. If you're having any problems setting up your XIM Apex, please visit zim.tech/support. Our active community forum has experts from all over the world ready to help. Even if you don't need any assistance, please consider joining our forum at community.zim.tech. XIM is a community-driven project where gamers like yourself share the insights and feedback that drive XIM's innovation and quality.